Hello everyone, I'm Ryan with PC Part Picker and welcome back to another build video. Today we're putting together a high-end Threadripper gaming machine. Thanks to Asus for providing the motherboard, graphics card, and processor for this build, and Anodys for providing their new Crystal Cube RGB case. Check the description below for a link to the full part list. Let's get started. Our motherboard for this build is the Asus ROG Zenith Extreme. It comes with a motherboard manual, USB key with the drivers, 6 SATA cables, fan hub, multiple RGB LED cables, temperature sensors, a GPU support bracket, several different SLI bridges, 10 gigabit Ethernet adapter, 2 wireless antennas, mounting hardware for M.2 drives, DIMM.2 card, and the motherboard itself. Loosen the screws following the order on the TR4 socket. The processor comes with a special screwdriver, or you can use a T20 Torx bit. Release and lift the CPU holder and remove the external cap. Remove the protective pin cover. Gently slide the processor into the CPU holder. Lower the CPU holder until it latches into place. Then close the TR4 socket cover and secure the screws in the indicated order. Before installing the memory, open the latches on all 8 DIMM slots. We're using 64 gigabytes of DDR4 3000 G-Skill Trident Z RGB memory. Align the DIMM with the notch in the DIMM slot. Push down on the top and it will click when secure. For storage, we're using a 1 TB Samsung 960 Pro NVMe SSD. Place the drive into the M.2 slot on the DIMM.2 card, then secure it with the mounting screw. Open the latch on the DIMM.2 slot, then take the card and align it with the small and large notches and set it into place. Our power supply for this build is the Seasonic 1200 Watt Prime Platinum. It comes with a variety of cables for different builds, and because it's fully modular, it means you only plug in the ones you plan to use. For our part list, we'll be using this set of cables. Connect the power cable starting with the 24 pin. The 2 EPS cables. Two of the 8-pin PCIe cables. Molex cable. And the SATA cable. Our case for this build is the Anodys AI Crystal Cube RGB. It's a dual chamber case that supports motherboards up to EATX. It has tempered glass panels for both sides as well as the front of the case. And it has 2 USB 3.0 and 2.0 ports, headphone and microphone jack, and a power and reset switch. Moving to the inside of the case, we have 4 intake fans. These are 120mm RGB fans. And on the back, we have a 120mm RGB exhaust fan. These are controlled by the proprietary controller at the back of the case. If you'd like to add more fans to your build, there's an additional fan controller for up to 7 more fans. You can mount 4 120mm fans at the top of the case, another one at the bottom of the case, and a 90mm fan at the rear. If you're looking to water cool your build, you can fit 2 240mm radiators at the top of the case, or 1 280mm, as well as a 240mm radiator at the front. The case has a dust filter for the top, on both sides of the front panel, and one more at the bottom of the case. Moving to the back, we have a cage for 2 3.5-inch drives, as well as mounting points for 3 2.5-inch drives, with an additional mounting point for either a 3.5 or 2.5-inch drive at the bottom of the case. Place the power supply in the rear chamber with the fan pointed towards the side panel. Secure the power supply with the provided screws.
The Crystal Cube RGB has the standoffs pre-installed in the correct position for our EATX motherboard. Gently take the motherboard and set it into the case, aligning it with the standoffs. Note that we didn't install a separate I/O shield because the Zenith Extreme has one built in. Secure the motherboard using the screws included with the case. Our cooler for this build is the Corsair H115i. Inside the box, we have mounting hardware for both AMD and Intel, Corsair link cable, and the radiator and fans. The TR4 mounting bracket is included with the processor. Place the fans on the radiator and secure them with the provided screws. Connect the radiator fans to the splitter from the CPU block. Gently position the radiator at the top of the case. And secure it with the screws and washers. Remove the plastic cover from the bottom of the CPU block. You'll notice that the thermal paste is already pre-applied. Press on the corners of the pre-installed bracket and twist to remove. Then place the TR4 mounting bracket on the CPU block and twist to secure. Align the mounting bracket with the holes around the CPU socket and secure it with the attached screws. Connect the cable from the CPU block to the CPU fan header. Connect the SATA power to the CPU cooler and to the RGB fan controller. Connect the Molex power to the case fan controller. We've already connected the front panel audio and USB 2.0 ports. ASUS provides a Q connector to easily plug in the front panel switches and LEDs. Plug it into the motherboard. Connect the front panel USB 3.0 cable. Then the 24-pin power cable. And the two 8-pin EPS power cables. Remove the first, second, fifth, and sixth expansion slot covers for our graphics cards. Raise the vanity plate by loosening the thumb screw, lifting it, and securing it back. We're using two ASUS GTX 1080 Ti Strix gaming graphics cards in SLI. Open the latches on the first and third X16 slots. Then remove the plastic covering from the graphics card and gently set it into place. Remove the protective covers from the SLI connectors on the graphics cards. Then connect the high bandwidth SLI bridge to both of the cards. Lower and secure the vanity cover. And secure the graphics cards with the screws we just removed. Connect all four 8-pin PCIe power cables to the graphics cards.
With all of our cables and components in place, let's flip the switch in the power supply and press the power button to give it a quick test boot before we manage the cables. And that's the screen we're looking for. All we have to do now is manage the cables and install the operating system. Thanks for joining us for another successful build video. And thanks to Anadies for providing the case and Asus for providing the motherboard, processor, and graphics card for this build. Be sure to check out our cable management video. And if you enjoyed our content or learned anything new, please give us a like and subscribe.